Hello and welcome to the Auntie Lisa Show. Today on the Auntie Lisa Show, excuse my yawn, will be the shrimp shack, a cat, a unicorn, a stunt plane, Hattie, and I think I'm going to throw in Andy, and us. So, one day, Auntie Lisa, Alexander and Christopher decided to go to the shrimp shack for some snacks. And it was a lovely, lovely sunny day. So they sat outside under one of those umbrellas, like the sunshades, and had delicious shrimp-based things. That was Alexander, Christopher, and Auntie Lisa had some chips. And everything was going absolutely fine. They're completely uneventful. Had a nice time, came home in the end. Only joking. Right, so anyway, everything was going fine. When a cat appeared. And that's not that unusual, you might think. But this cat was going meow, 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 and rubbing around everybody's legs. And Auntie Lisa was like, oh no! Alexander Christopher's like, what's wrong, Auntie Lisa? And Auntie Lisa, I'm allergic to cats. They make me sneeze, especially when they've got fleas. That rhymes. And Alexander went, ooh, that cat does look a bit ropey. I think he might have fleas, you know, Auntie Lisa. Christopher went, ooh, I can see some fleas jumping off of him. Yuck. But the cat looks such a state. Meow. Alexander and Christopher snuck that cat some little bits of shrimp, and the cat looked much happier. And it started to purr. And Auntie Lisa went, oh, it's kind of sweet though, isn't it? I wonder if it's a homeless cat. We better find out if it's got an owner. Hey, can you guys pick that cat up? Because I surely can't. It makes me... And as she sneezed, all her chips flew onto the floor. She was like, my chips fell on the floor. Alexander and Christopher went, which was not very sympathetic. So, Auntie Lisa was well upset. But anyway, she got over it, she'd grown up and she could buy more. It was fine. So Alexander picked up the cat and the cat went, meow. And he said, Auntie Lisa, this cat is super skinny. I don't think it's got a home. And Christopher gave the cat a little stroke on the head and it went, and Auntie Lisa said, oh God, now we have to go and find the cat a home. So, she said, okay, we got to take it to the vets. That's job number one. Because, what if it does have an owner and it's just got lost? We might be able to find out. So, they kidnapped the cat from outside the shrimp shack. By which I mean, they chucked it in the back of Auntie Lisa's car and off they drove. Auntie Lisa's good at kidnapping other people's pets. She once kidnapped someone's dog from outside their house. But in her defence, they shouldn't have left it roaming around the streets. Could have got run over. But anyway, quite silly. There we go. It was fine. Anywho, so they took it straight to the vets. And when they got to the vet went, ooh, dear, look at all those fleas. Pa-ding, pa-ding, pa-ding. The fleas were jumping about all over the place. Vet said, this cat is in a disgraceful state. Where on earth did you find it? I explained, they found it at the shrimp shack. And Aunt Lisa was still struggling not to sneeze. It was a bad day. Anyway, the vet said, we will check if anyone has lost a cat recently. And so, the vet did this. Ooh. Do you know what? Somebody has lost a cat recently. How interesting. Alexander and Christoph said, what? What's interesting about it? What is it? Why is it interesting? And the vet said, well, put it this way. This is a very, very unusual person that has lost a cat. Let me scan the cat for a chip. I'll just double check it's theirs. And sure enough, the scan came back as that person's cat. I expect you're wondering whose cat it was. Well, I will tell you. The vet said, okay. You're gonna need to go on a bit of a mission to find this person because they live in the deepest, darkest depths of the woods. And Aunt Elise went, ooh, the deepest, darkest depths of the woods. What kind of person is this? And the vet said, well, I'm not one to gossip. But between you and me, rumour has it this person is a witch. And Aunt Elise went, ooh, I'm sure that's just a silly rumour. Alexander and Christoph went, ooh, a witch. A nice one or a horrible one? Aunt Elise said, ooh, good question. What kind of a witch are we dealing with here? And the vet said, well, it really depends on how you feel about being turned into a frog. Aunt Elise said, not good, not good. Don't want to be turned into a frog anytime soon. And she said, well, have you been mean to anybody lately? And Aunt Elise said, I don't think so. Have you, Alexander? Alexander shook his head. Christopher? And the vet said, well, in that case, I think you'll probably be fine. Because, I mean, it's just a rumour. Apparently, anyway, this lady turned someone into a frog who had been mean to other people in the village. And Aunt Elise said, well, if they were mean, then that's probably okay. What did they do? And the vet said, I don't know. You'll have to find out. And they said, okay. The vet said, well, I'm going to give this cat some special flea spray and we'll give it a good meal and then you guys are on your own. You got to take that cat back because I'm not going anywhere near the deep, dark depths of the wood. And goodness me, we don't want that lady visiting us here. Oh no. Last time she came, all the dogs started howling and all the cats started going crazy and running around in circles. And as for the other animals, well, half of them just passed out. It was most strange. They were fine later, but it was most strange. Nobody was happy. So, Aunt Elise said, well, I'm sure it's just all rumour. It's probably just an old lady who's preferred to live on her own. Personally, I can understand that. Sometimes other people can be really annoying. Not you guys, obviously, Alexander and Christopher, but you know, other people. So, anyway, the vet took the cat off to give it some special treatment and some extra food. And meanwhile, Alexander, Christopher and Aunt Elisa sat around in the waiting room, twiddling their thumbs. When who should arrive but Hattie and Andy? Ah! Aunt Elisa's like, what brings you two here? I didn't know you had a pet at the Natural History Museum. And Hattie and Andy said, well, funny thing happened today. We were just arrived at the museum when we heard a terrible clattering around. And Aunt Elise said, ooh, what was it? And they said, it was a bat! A bats that had got lost in the Natural History Museum and it had bashed into one of the windows, and we think it's got a bit of a concussion and a slightly broken wing, so we thought we'd better bring it to the vets." Owsley said, "Oh, that was really kind of you, but of course I would expect you to be kind. So let's have a look at this bat." Well, Aunt Elisa and Alexander Kristoff peered into the box. And a little tiny creature peered out like this. And Aunt Elisa went, "It's so cute. Look at it. Oh, I hope it will be okay." And Hattie and Andy said, "Of course it will be okay. Don't worry, Aunt Elisa. We're going to take great care of it." So, by and by, the vet returned and gave Aunt Elisa and Alexander and Christopher the instructions of how to get to the witch, the old lady's house in the deepest, darkest depths of the woods. It was a very complicated journey and actually quite a long way. And Aunt Elisa gave it some thought and thought to herself, "You know what? There's a quicker way to get to the deepest, darkest depths of the woods instead of taking the car and then hiking all the way up this mountain and down this ravine and into the deepest, darkest depths of the woods. We can take the plane, the stunt plane, I'm sure El Fuego won't mind, and we will land the stunt plane just down river of the witch's house, I mean old lady's house, and then we'll just canoe up the river. It'll be fine. I'm sure the cat won't mind. Cats love water, right?" Everybody shook their head in dismay. "Cats do not like water, Auntie Lisa," said Alexander and Christopher. Auntie went, "Oh yeah. Well, it's okay. The cat will be in a carrier. All will be well. This can't go wrong. It's a brilliant plan." So they called up El Fuego and he said, "Hey, Alexander, Christopher, he's turned Italian. I don't know why. Anyway, he said, hey, of course, let's go in my stunt plane. I love an adventure. Let's do this. Save the cats." So, here, Alexander, Christopher, and Aunt Elisa and the cat went to find El Fuego and his stunt plane. It wasn't hard because it was parked up outside JB's lab. As you do. Anyway, so they set off for the deepest, darkest depths of the woods. El Fuego got the engine running. Sounds like a motorbike. More of a... It was absolutely fine, don't worry. It's perfectly safe. The cat was like this. But lucky it was inside a cage. Otherwise, I think it might have scratched everyone's tiny pieces as the stunt plane took off into the air. El Fuego was about to do a loop-de-loop when Aunt Elisa went, "No! Think of the cat." El Fuego went, "Oh, good point. I'll try and fly this thing super calmly." It was taking all of his self-control not to do a loop-de-loop. But eventually they came to the strip of land next to the river where they met an old friend with a canoe. A canoe, a lovely canoe, a big lovely canoe, which turns out Aunt Elisa knows how to paddle. Woohoo! So they all climbed aboard the canoe. And Aunt Elisa said, "We got everybody in?" El Fuego went, "Of course, we're ready." Alexander and Christopher had their special safety extra buoyant vests on. So did Aunt Elisa for safety. And they attached some extra buoyancy to the cat's cage too, just in case it fell overboard. That would be a disaster because it would sink like a stone to the bottom. But it won't because it's got extra little buoyancy things attached to the side. Anyway, oh God, who knows where this is going. Right, so off they went down river. Aunt Elise was paddling at the front. Everything was going fine. And all of a sudden they hit some crazy turbulent water, which means it was really choppy, really bumpy, really big waves. And Auntie was like, "Everybody hold on!" And everyone went, ah! We should have driven and hiked. It would have been easier. Anyway. Luckily, they did not capsize. It was close, though. And they came up to the darkest, darkest bit of the woods. It was dark and cold in the middle of the woods, and the trees grew over the river like hands enclosing it. And Alexander and Christopher looked around and went, it is a bit spooky here, Auntie Lisa. Are you sure this was a good idea? Auntie said, let's hope so. She's probably just a lovely old lady who's really missing her cat. Well. Eventually, Alexander said, hey, look over there. Christoph said, yes, it's a house on the side, on the edge by the river. Quick, Auntie Lisa, let's get there quick. So they got to the house and they attached the boat by a rope to a tree next to the river, and they all clambered out with the cat in the basket still. You know, one of them cages, carry case things. And they walked slowly up to the door. And the door was a big, dark, wooden door with one of those scary knockers with a scary face on it like this. And everyone thought, uh-oh, I hope it's gonna be okay. Auntie Lisa said, quick, one of you knock. Alexander Crystal went, I don't want to knock. Elfair went, I'll knock. And it clanged all through the house. And everybody stood back like this. And then, the door opened. And a most horrifying face appeared like this.
Who are you? What do you want? And Auntie Lisa went,
I'm Auntie Lisa, and we found your cat. We found your cat. Look, look, see? Cat. And then the face went, my cat. My beautiful bus cat, Jeff. He's been gone for so long. I'd given up hope. Where did you find him? Alexander said, we found him at the shrimp shack. We gave him some shrimp. He had fleas, but now he doesn't. We gave him some medicine at the vet's. And the old lady went, you're so kind. How will I ever repay you? Christopher said, please don't turn us into frogs. That will be enough and we will go home now. Thank you very much. Bye-bye. And she said, turn you into frogs? I would never do that to you. You brought back my darling Jeff. And anyway, of course, I never turn anyone into frogs ever. Well, she said, would you young people like a nice cup of tea and some cake? And I said, I do like cake. And she said, okay, I've got a lovely picnic blanket. Let's have a picnic outside. Oh, I'm going to let Jeff the cat out straight away. And she let out Jeff the cat, and Jeff the cat went. He was super happy to see his lovely friend. And she explained that her name was Edith, and she was, technically speaking, but don't tell anybody, technically a witch. And everyone went, ooh, but a good witch, right? And she went, well, of course. To nice people, I'm a good witch. And since you have been so kind to me, I will help you out in some way. What would you like most of all in all the world? And Aunt Elise said, A unicorn! And a unicorn appeared at last in front of Aunt Elise, and she went, Hooray! I've got a unicorn! And she jumped on top of that unicorn and went clippity 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 clip and ran all around in circles on top of this beautiful unicorn that was purple with a rainbow unicorn horn and a rainbow tail and a rainbow mane. And she was the happiest Auntie Lisa you could ever find. And Alexander said, My turn, my turn, my turn. Can I have, please, a robot T-Rex dinosaur Lego set that has a volcano with gold in it? And maybe, ooh, just one more thing, a Lego Ghostbuster set. And she went, And there appeared the bestest Lego sets in the world that he wanted. And he went, Yes! Thank you so much! I'm gonna build them straight away! And it started building them. And Christopher said, Can I have the Triceratops escape set, please? And she said, But of course! There, the Triceratops escape set was right in front of him. And he went, Started building it. And then she said, And you, Elfuego, I believe you helped out with your lovely stunt plane. And Elfuego went, Ha-ha! Well, I think I have all I ever wanted in this world. Apart from. And she said, Yes. And he said, Well, I would actually really quite like a stunt rocket. And she said, Pfft, a stunt rocket, Elfuego. And he said, Yes, please, if that's not too much trouble. And she said, Okay. And there appeared a stunt rocket ship, which could do loop-de-loops on its way to the moon and then loop-de-loops on its way back home. Elfuego was so excited. He was like, Let's try it now! And so everybody, including Edith the Witch and Jeff the Cat and Aunt Elisa and her new unicorn, whose name was gonna be Rainbow Stripes, and Alexander with all his Lego and Christopher with all his Lego, decided to go on a special trip into space on a Fuego stunt rocket. And it was the best, most exciting trip into space, going round and whirling up and down, that anyone has ever been on. And that is the end of the story. I love you. Night night.